Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and hospitality simple. In this video, I'm going to show you how I've organized my walk-in pantry. I am slowly transitioning this pantry to more of a long-term food storage. And here you can see that I've already started. Now you'll see some scratches and stuff on the wall because I used to have wallpaper there. And so eventually I'm going to wallpaper this walk-in pantry and make it look a lot nicer. But for now, this is how it looks and this is how I've organized it. And it's very functional for what I need. And then I added this. This is an over-the-door shoe holder that I got from Target. You can get cheaper ones. I'll put a link. And I decided to put this on because with the idea of making it more long-term food storage, I wanted to make sure I had enough of the condiments and sauces and spices that I use. Right now, I went through my pantry and I could make 10 meals from this pantry because it's all condiments. So that's one thing that I'm learning. Go through your pantry, look at what meals can you actually make from the pantry, not putting in stuff from your fridge or your freezer or other places that, grabbing something at the store. What do you have on hand now? And so that's what I looked at. I have 10 meals. And so I'm going to work towards this providing 1 month of food. That's why I'm getting into long-term food storage or, longer-term food storage more than what I can make in a week. And then I always make sure I have oyster sauce and this Maggie liquid seasoning or Knorr, just different brands, but it's a liquid seasoning. It's hard to explain. It's kind of like soy sauce. So I like to have those on hand. And I just have candy. I've had these forever. Cookbooks that I used to have, I think, three times as many cookbooks, so I've kept it to this. If you want to see my recipe binder, I'll link it up in the iCards. This is a two-tier Lazy Susan, which is perfect. Again, if you have deep shelves or it's higher, you just have to turn this and grab the one that is in front. So a Lazy Susan, look for corners in your pantry, whether it's in a cabinet or it's a narrow pantry or a small pantry. A Lazy Susan is probably a good solution for you. And then here, these are from the Container Store. I think this larger one is $5.99, and then they have a medium and a small. So here I have onions and garlic that needs to be filled up. I have here Pop-Tarts and breakfast, some bars, and then I think trail mix, and then potatoes. Yeah, my potatoes look sad. Don't vilify me, please. Okay, and then here I have some OXO containers. Here I have some tea, more tea there. So I have Chinese tea there, Indian tea here, that's what I call it. Some breadcrumbs and some panko there. Now I only have these jars in this OXO because this is an extra one. I didn't want to put it away, so I'm just having it here in case I need it. Here's some more drinks. So this is kind of like my drink section. This is where stuff for like pancakes, so like syrup and toppings, some condiments, some more pickled type of condiments. And then, so you see that my shelves are not adjustable. I did put a liner on them. So when your shelves are not adjustable, you have to kind of play Tetris, right? With the baskets or the bins or the containers that you get. So that's what I've done. And I found that these baskets from Target, they're really durable and they fit. They're the perfect size. I can pull it out, see what's inside, or I can even see what's inside from just standing here. And then I use the label maker, as you see, on almost everything here. And a lot of that is for me to remember when I replenish things, where do they go? Or if my family returns things, where do they go? They're kind of used to it, but still, it's nice to have a reminder. And then here we just have snacks, which is basically a bunch of chips, pasta. So I try to have 4 meals worth of pasta available at all times. And you know, pasta is running out right now. So one meal is 2 of these for our family. Okay. So popcorn and other stuff like crackers and raisins and some gravy, popcorn seasoning. Okay. We even have popcorn holders there. Okay, this is my Asian one, whether it's more sauces, Asian soup, these things, I forgot what they're called. I love these. what are they called? You fry them. Oh yeah, papad. Papad, yeah. Did I say that right? Some more sauces here. Okay, these I got from the container store. They're the same kind of containers as those, but they're the smaller size. So these are $3.99. And these are basically all my canned goods. So when I started prepping a few years ago, these are the things that I bought because I knew I wanted to keep some canned food. Before that, I didn't really get canned food, but you know, canned food is a hot commodity right now. So I have here some chili, black beans, you can see some fruit, veggies, and some coconut milk. I use that all the time when I cook, and then some evaporated milk there. So here I started my long-term food storage. I learned to dry can pasta, crackers, rice, oatmeal, and some cereal and quinoa. There is actually space above here for another 36 mason jars. So I'm gonna try to find a shelf because it's not very stable stacking them on top of each other. Okay, down here is rice, and more rice because rice is life. Here's another solution. You could get one of these things that go under the shelf to add more stuff. So here we usually put raw peanuts and taco shells. And then all this stuff is for baking. So you could see I've labeled it flour, pancake mixes, vanilla and colors, meaning coloring. And yeah, sugar. Okay, so these are the stairs. So this ceiling kind of goes down like that. So it was perfect to put this inexpensive Sterilite plastic drawers that we got from Walmart. And this is where my daughter keeps all her baking stuff because she loves to bake and she's a great baker. Let me open up one so you can see. So even inside, we don't just throw it all in. We use this drawer organizer or utensil organizer to make sure that's nice and tidy. Here on the left, we are ketchup lovers. So I just have this. This is supposed to be for like aluminum foil, but I went ahead and put it on the wall here. And then we just keep a couple bottles of ketchup on hand because we love ketchup. Okay, then we have this other rolling drawer, plastic drawers. Again, very inexpensive. Our air fryer is on top. I used to have it on our counter, but now I have an AeroGarden, a pasta maker, of course, inspired by my pasta making class. Here's stuff for meal prep and the mason jar lids. And this is other rice, like sweet rice, glutinous rice. So you see here that these plastic drawers are stationary. And then this one has wheels on it so we can roll it out, get it out of the way if she needs something here when it's time for her to bake. Okay, here to the left, I just have a nail. All right, so that is my walk-in pantry tour for beginner preppers. Start thinking about how much food do you actually have here without the fridge, without the freezer, to make meals. And then start your long-term food storage. Hey, do me a favor, I'd love to know. Go to your pantry and let me know how many meals can you make out of only things in your pantry right now. Leave it in the comments below, and I hope you enjoyed this video. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All this time you thought would never pay the price.